Hello friends, how are you? Hope you all are doing well. And thank you for liking my last videos. So let's start with new topic, Angular 9 Material Datatable with PHP MySQL Data. On my screen, you can see that the beautiful data table, and that is Material Datatable, and the data is showing in that table is coming from my PHP backend. Now let me show you my database and add some data. This is my database, and let me add some more data. I will add 7 rows. Then I will also show the material data table. Pagination is also working fine. 5, now one more, 6, now I have 6 rows. Now let me refresh. Now friends, on my screen you can see the data. Now I have shown only 5 rows. Now I will show you the item per page 10. Now have you seen the item per page is working fine. Now I will also show you the pagination. Look, the pagination works beautifully, and the layout of material data table is also very beautiful. Now I will tell you how to include, how to implement material data table in our Angular 9 application. First, after set up the Angular 9 on your machine, you have to run this command, ng add @angular/material. Please note down, you have to run this command into your command prompt. After run this command, you have to run ng serve command again. You have to run ng serve command again, and after it, please open your app.module.ts file. And into your app.module.ts file, you have to import these 4 things. Please note down, import HTTP client, import mat paginator module, import mat table module, import browse animation module. Please note down, and don't worry, I will share the post link also. Please note down also. After it, you have to mention these all name into your import array. Please note down, mat paginator module, mat table module, browse animation module, and HTTP client module. Fine. After it, open your app.component.ts file. In this file, on the top, you have to import mat paginator, mat table data source, HTTP client, and data source. Fine. After it, I have initialized some variables like display columns is equal to, and that is my database columns name, and I have mentioned an array, ID, email, first name. Let me show you again. My database, ID, email, first name. Great. After it, you have to initialize data source, mat data source, any means array, string, boolean, any type. And after inside constructor, you have to initialize private HTTP object to HTTP client. And after it, our HTTP API call and here is your localhost slash my page.php file. In that file, I have added my MySQL query for get the data. Look, con is equal to new SQLi your localhost php my admin username, password and database name. After it, your select query, select star from user data, result con query SQL, and I have initialized array. If number of rows are greater than 0, then in while loop I put the value in array and I echo the array in JSON format. Great. Now let's come to here. After the API call, I put my all API data in post array variable that I have mentioned here. This dot post dot push dot data, and after it, in the data source mat data table, I put all the data, and after it, I initialize the mat originator, and inside my ng on init function, I have set the origination rows number, and here I have interface my periodic elements ID, number, email string, first name string, and here is my HTML code. You can see that. I will also share the my blog post link from where you can get the data. So friends, you can see that the Angular 9 Material Datatable is working fine with PHP MySQL data. And if you have a query, so please comment on this video. And friend, please subscribe my channel. I will come with more posts. And if you have any requirement, then you can also comment on this video, and I will also share my email ID, and you can also post my email ID also your requirements. So thank you friends, have a nice day. So please like my video and subscribe my channel. Thank you.